To start off our Friday edition, we welcome in the new Executive Director of the College and Career Access Center at Jackson Crossing, Nancy Peters-Lewis. Hi, Nancy.
Hi.
Nice to see you. Welcome.
Nice to be here. Thank you for having me.
And welcome to your new job.
Yes. Yeah. It's a wonderful place. Great, great place to be. We're located, like you said, right out at Jackson Crossing. And so we have a twofold approach. We have the open access center where the public can come in and get career and college advising free of charge. Mm-hmm. And then we also have a team of advisors that go out into the Jackson County schools and do college and career advisings alongside the counselors in the schools that already are doing a fabulous job. And we just come behind them reinforcing the information and tying up any loose ends and making sure that the students are on a pathway to a college or career.
And originally you were just the College Access Center. You added career to the title and also to your menu of services.
Yes, absolutely. And that's something that we're really trying to develop this year, even more of a framework, working with Career Jumpstart, Michelle Shields over at Jackson College, really looking at tools that are going to help our students and the population in general look at careers and career training programs as valuable credentials in addition to two and four-year college prep programs.
What's your background? Did you come from the education world?
Actually, I have a really interesting background. I initially grew up in Jackson, proud Jackson Viking, and went to Albion College for undergrad. And my bachelor's is in economics and international studies with a minor in French. Lived abroad in West Africa for 18 months, and then I started to pursue, when I got out, a career with the government. I was a translator and worked for the Social Security Administration, and then I taught English as a second language. That was back when you didn't need a TESOL, and did that, and really enjoyed that, and felt, you know, this is kind of a calling for me. I really am enjoying the education side and also the community development part. Then I took a little hiatus, did some private grant writing at home, and also worked in our business at home. And then I came out, worked for the College Access Network, was actually the parallel to the C2C coordinator here over in Albion, and continued over in Battle Creek where I was just the education director. And so I'm here now. I'm very excited.
Welcome home.
Thank you. Glad to be here. Glad to be here.
Do you recall when you were a high school senior deciding about college, what kinds of challenges that you faced when you tried to plan things for what today's seniors are looking at?
Yes, actually, you know, what really drives my passion through all of this is a dichotomy that I saw very early on. I was originally in a private school setting, and my parents pulled us out of private school, put us in public schools, and I really realized right away, it was very apparent to me that there were discrepancies in society at a very young age, and I'm thankful that my parents put us in an environment that allowed us to be able to see that. And so even in high school, I'm third generation on my father's side, but my mother's side, all 10 of their kids were first generation college going students. And so personally, I saw the discrepancy that existed in hearing their stories and their personal histories. And then also, my husband was first generation and we met at Albion College. He's from Jackson as well. And it's a totally different ballgame for first generation students. Students that don't have the opportunity that I had, having that already ingrained at a very young age. And I want to see to that playing field leveled. And so it really drives me. And the things that really exist are that are not as easy for first generation students to have access to are just two simple things. The affordability of college.
Sure.
And really getting through that process and finding out how that works. And then the navigation of college. And that includes just filling out college applications, getting to a campus to actually see what a campus actually looks like to get that feel for it. And getting that process completed and admitted and be ready to go when they graduate. So I had a pretty easy time of it because of my status as a third generation person, but I was able to see the difficulty for other people.
A kid whose mom and dad did not go to college, do they grow up in a home thinking that that's the way it's going to be for them, or is it just the opposite, that their parents really want to make sure that they're the first kid in the family that does go to college?
Well, I'm a big believer that everybody wants their kid to be successful, you know? I mean, that's just a given. Nobody says, I don't want my kid to go to college. Everybody wants their kid to be a success. The process is gaining the knowledge of how to get them there. It's for instance, I speak two languages, French and Wolof. If I wouldn't have been taught that, I wouldn't know how to speak that.
What's the other language?
It's called Wolof. It's a Senegalese. It's in West Africa.
Oh, sure. Yeah, I speak a little of that.
Yeah. Negative.
Oh, don't do it.
Megafurek. No. But yeah, I'll teach
this
you.
This is a
afterwards.
Family show.
Right.
I hope it was.
They'll love it. They'll love it. I'll give a lesson at another time. So yeah, so really. Everybody wants their child to go to college or to be successful. They want them to be successful. It doesn't mean we look at college as a valuable credential. So nowadays, you know, you can't just go and necessarily work in a factory and be able to support a family of five like you could 20, 30 years ago. You really have to have a valuable credential, whether that be in welding, whether that be in some manufacturing field. And so we look at post-secondary navigation as either a 2 to 4 year degree, a college, or a valuable credential from a training center.
My nephew, mm-hmm. who starts his senior year this month mm-hmm. in high school, just got accepted last week at Central Michigan.
Yeah.
And I thought, what? Isn't that early? Is this has it moved up the application process?
Well, yes. Actually, it hasn't necessarily moved up from when I was doing it, 20 something years ago, but there are early application deadlines. U of M, end of October, you know, Michigan State, there are early application deadlines. But we actually have College Application Week, which is November 4th through November 8th, where we want to see all of our high school seniors in all the Jackson County schools apply to a post-secondary institution. So the drive is to really get your college applications or your post-secondary applications completed by mid-November at the very latest. And then we go into the affordability process, which is the FAFSA completion, which is what actually helps to pay for your schooling. And that starts in January. And in between those times, we look at scholarships. We start to look at scholarship season. And then those kind of run into each other together, and we want to tie up all of those, the funding pieces and the admittance pieces. And then we go into what we call summer melt, which is where we really hone in on those students who may be most at risk for not showing up to an institution in the fall.
People that have gotten, they got accepted, they've got all their dollars lined up, and they mm-hmm. still don't show up.
They still don't show up for circumstances. Mm-hmm. And there's risk factors that we used. All of the Jackson County schools, which are amazing. It's amazing, really, I have to tell you. I'm proud to be from Jackson, because coming back to Jackson and seeing this collective impact model that's actually not just being talked about, but it's really, people are on board. I just this week presented at the Counselors Association's meeting, the Principals Association's meeting, and the Superintendents Association's meeting. And these people are all at the table from different schools in Jackson County coming together to try to figure this thing called education out together. And so they're putting their independent agendas aside to really come together and push education for all students in Jackson County. So it's really amazing to see. And I'm impressed, and I'm really glad to be a part of it.
It's nice to hear, especially from someone coming in from outside to see and comment on how good we've got it here.
Yeah, it's great. It's great.
So you also as a school, have essentially semesters, how you work. You mentioned the college application week and the uh-huh. FAFSA period and MELT
yes.
period.
What's yes.
What's the fourth one?
Well, scholarships.
Scholarships.
Yeah,
okay.
Scholarships. And yes, that's ongoing, but it really starts in the beginning of October. Jackson Community Foundation has a wonderful array of different scholarships, and we help to administer those at the College and Career Access Center. And people can come into our center. They can get resume help. They can get scholarship help. They get FAFSA help, TIP eligibility help. Anything that they need help with college and career, we're there to serve them, and it's all free of charge.
Awesome. And you're located in Jackson Crossing?
Yes, right across from Target.
Someone wants to stop in, that's all they need to do, right?
Yep, they can stop in, and we have folks available, or they can call and set up an appointment.
Great. Welcome, and thanks for coming on the show.
Thanks so much for having me. It was fun.
You bet. The new executive director of the College and Career Access Center, Nancy Peters-Lewis.
Thank you.